Hi guys. It's almost quarter to nine in the evening. And I've been very busy today. The framework for the table is complete. I just want to make a modification on this end. I'm going to get rid of these two angled brackets and just cut a straight piece from this and pretty much do what I've done across the bottom there. I just want something in there because I can just see me walking up here and then catching my foot on the bottom there. So that may take the leg off. So, and I think a bar going across what I've done just down there and there would make life easier. As for the lights, I've gone for that option. I've just got to wire it up, but I can't do that yet. And I'm actually going to make a modification, because I want to use that for lighting effects as well, with some coloured light bulbs. I'm, bear with me for a sec. See if I can get hold of the basket. I'm going to hopefully, this depends on the rating of the switches as well, but I'm going to hopefully put a dimmer in. That can take up to 1,000 watt. Ooh, that's quite a big one. I've got a double in here. What's this one? That's 60 to 250 watt. That's still plenty big enough for those two spots. If I won't get to use a dimmer, I could use a double standard switch. Aha! Double dimmer. What's this one like? To 250 watt. Oh yeah, more than enough. They're probably only going to be like maximum 60 watt on each switch, so more than enough. More than enough. Let's see if I've got any more while I've got the box open. What's this? Oh, well, that old thing. That's a really old dimmer switch. Changed that in a house mum was in a few years ago, but I can't remember why. That's good. The reason I've got to put a double on, not a single, is because that'll allow me to change the light effect better, because I could have one bright, one dim. Or whatever I feel like. I'm gonna change that. I might remember. Okay, so common on one end. Put your power in and live to out the bottom end. I believe. I will double check that. I do not want to go bang. And yeah, I'll put a couple of dimmers to do with moving the switch, really. Then again, I can lean over and reach, so that will do. It's just a matter of swapping the switch over. And I'll need to put a power link in. I'll have to link common to common. But, apart from that, that'll work. So that's the main project I've been doing today. 3 sections. That's one section. That corner has another section. Then I've got the main section here, which was actually twisted because that leg was off the floor, but it seems to have dropped now and settled. Yeah, because that pole did have screwed to the end here, because I was going to put another spotlight on there, but then I figured, well, it would be easier and better just to do what I did there and use the fourth spotlight I had. So what I've done is screwed it up so far. I've just got to, well, I need the connection unit, one of these, one more of those, because I've got to extend the cable because it won't reach the switch. Same with the earth, extend that, and then just wire up the dimmer switch. That's if I don't decide to move the switch lower down. Lower on the wall, that is. I'm trying, I'm torn with the idea, because it might actually make it easier to get to. Won't be hard to do. Just have to pull that black cable back. Dear me. Yeah. But I would still need one of those connectors, because I'd have to lengthen at least one. No, I'd actually have to lengthen both, wouldn't I? That'd be easier to leave the switch where it is. Sort it, just leave it where it is. Go off. Right. I've got bed to clear. I've got a photograph of that to take. And the other thing I've been doing, computers have gone from the corner, apart from one. Yeah, they haven't gone very far. First sort out laptop cupboard. I've managed to stack them up there. Took the computers off this shelf. One is up there, the little beige, creamy coloured e-machines thing. And that Dell is an 1100 case, and there's no CD drive in it. I don't know about floppy drive. And it's just a future project. Same with these Dells here. Stacked all the keyboards nice and tidily on top. There's a VCR hidden up the back there as well. All the motherboards are nicely stacked in here. I've thrown the Apple Mac up on the wardrobe. And the Power Edge and the two working Dells are here. We've got is that 1100? Yeah. This one's the 1100 with the floppy drive. The Windows 2000 one, the 2400, that's there, and that doesn't have a floppy drive. Actually, what I might do is take the hard drive out of there and see if I can get it to work on the 1100. Because I've got two 1100 cases. But then again, they're all flipping the same, aren't they? Near enough. Power Edge don't work. I've got that big old Dell up the corner there to look at. Case there to scrap. Plus I've got other cases in the kitchen to play with. So I'm not short of a case or two. Still got some sorting out to do in here. I'll swap that cabinet with the server. I want that flat surface to put a laptop on. Who's doing me? Been busy sorting lots of stuff out and rearranging things, and I think I've got a bit more organisation going on now. I hope. I wouldn't want to sit on this table because it isn't Well, I didn't build it strong enough to take, like, my weight. I'm not even sure I'm going to get down there yet to do me a window display. But, I shall think of something. I might be able to squeeze along there. So, I'll clear this table, because it's full of tools and things where I've been busy. I think the raid can actually go back under the sink, because I ain't going to need that now. Can go away, that can go away. Should be going over to Mum's Thursday, so hopefully, if Stepdad's got any, of course, I'll get some ply cut to put on the top of that. And, I was just thinking I probably could have done with another support in the centre there, but, yeah. I think that'd be fine. But, mind you, I've got the wood there to do it with, so I could easily whack it in there. It wouldn't be hard. Just to stop the ply from bowing too much, that's all. But I don't think it will, to be honest. Because I think most of the weight, which will be the buildings themselves, will be along the edges anyway. Because the road will probably go down the middle, because I'm hoping I can, I'm not sure, but I'm hoping I could probably get three. Or it might overlap. If I overlap, like that, then yeah, I could. Then I could put the road down the middle and buildings on either side. And actually have, sweet, that's worked out better than I thought. I don't mind having a bit of an overlap like that. If push come to shove, I can bring the table towards me, from that wall towards me. Yeah, so long as, you know, 95% of the baseboards are on the table, and so long as I join the baseboards together, yeah, my idea was, and this will be in more detail on the Lego channel, is I'll put a curve in here, so the road will come down the middle of this one, curve, and then round onto this one. That's the general plan. Whew. Now, I've been thinking about my die-cast cars. I've got so many of them. And as much as I like collecting them, I'm not doing anything with them. So I don't know whether to try and sell some or... But there's a hell of a lot there to, like, put on eBay. I'll be there for a long, long time doing that. I don't know what to do with them. I won't get the top one here now, so I can start laying out the street. Yeah. Oh, crap. The overhangs at the back there. I may not get down there to dress the window for Christmas. Because I'm not sure. It's going to be a tight squeeze, is it? Well, I could. And I suppose I could just move the tower when it's on there temporarily, just slide it across a bit if I need to. So yeah, that's alright. It'll be a squeeze, but I can get down there. That's what I want to do, put that extension socket under the table. Oh, and shorten the power cable for the spots. I need a couple of clips just to clip that white sky cable around with the radio antenna cable, which is what the black one is. Just so that clips up and behind the curtain out of the way. Because, I think because of that outlet on the wall, I may put like a park area up there, just a couple of these. I think I will need some more green base plates. So I've got buildings on some. But they're not too expensive. I'll grab some of those. I've got a few spare. Or two or three spare. So, yeah, chuck a couple up in that corner. I won't really know what I'm going to do until I actually get the road in. But I can't do anything until I've got the bloody top on. Can't sit anything. Can't sit things on an invisible surface. Well, that's what that looks like at the moment, doesn't it? Invisible. I smell someone's got a bloody bonfire. Anyway. I've got lots of crap on here, sort out. What do you want? Really? I'm actually thinking of, uprating the bulbs in here to the maximum 100 watt, because 60 watt is okay, but let's see what 100 watt's like, because they are my work lights after all. I thought 260 watt bulbs would be okay, but that actually reminds me. Back in the bedroom. Just gonna sit you on the floor here and look under the bed and knows all the junk I've got under here. Aha! That's alright. Need a bulb up here. Yep. What's this one? Is that 100? That's 100 watt. What's this one? That's a 60. Oh, that's a BC as well. I might. I think. That's a 75 watt, but that's a BC as well. I do need a 60. Or something lower. Well, there's a 40 watt, because I can't remember what I put in the existing spotlight above the, what's going to be the display table. I've got 100 watt here. I've got a 40 watt. But I will take that one out of there, at the end there, and just see if that's a 40 or a 60. I just want to know if 100's going to be too bright. It certainly looks better. That's why I hate Edison screw. Okay. It's definitely bright. Right. What did I stick in this one? Did I stick 40 in this one? Can't see. Oops. Let's get under the light and see if I can see it. Made in the UK. No, this one is a 60 watt. And I don't think I've got... Well, actually, I have got a 60 watt, because I just took it out of that. Anyway. Dum-dum. It's only to illuminate the display up this corner. Which one was it? This one. That's the 60, I believe. Getting this one ready. That should illuminate the display a lot better. That's all wired up and whatnot. Okay, so I need. Hopefully, if I've got enough change Thursday, I'll get another 100 watt. I don't think I have one. I will double check the box in the bedroom. But I will also check up here. Something actually stinks in here. Found it. Yeah, I don't have one in there. I thought I had one in a packet. Those are all coloured. I'm just going to be part of the Christmas display. Let's have another look in here. I think most of them are just small. I've got those ones, but they're BC, not Edison screw. Don't need Edison screw, lads. I need Edison screw. I think most of these are actually 40s as well. What I've got left in here. Big ass tube. 60 watt. Big ass energy saver. I did have two of those, but one got left in an outside light where Mum was living 2 years ago. All sorts of bulbs in here, and most of them you can't get anymore at this shape. No idea why they shaped it like that. These, believe it or not, most of these were left in the wooden shed where Mum currently lives. That was just shitloads of weird and wonderful shaped bulbs. So, me being me, you know, and having this fixation with light bulbs and things, I actually found these clear ones. They're 25 watt, I believe. Yep. In one of the wheelie bins out on the car park a few years ago. The best thing is, because they're clear like that, I can see if they're good or not. That's one advantage about those clear bulbs. I've got candle bulb. I've got one of these bulbs. I've had that years, and it's followed me around. But, that plate glows orange, so it looks like an actual candle, allegedly. But, I've got all sorts in here. I've got energy savers of all shapes and sizes. It's got an SES end on it. BT. That's an LED golf ball, that one. It's got a plastic top. And that's a filament one. I can't remember. I think I've got a couple of these LED ones. Oh, hello. That's not what I thought. I've got candles, bowls, all sorts in there. And yes, they all do work. Well, they did work when I put them in here. Oh, I've even got pygmy. Little 15 watt pygmy bulb. And years ago I used to have a string of party lights that took those. But we were moving home and I went back to the shed, as we had to go back to the house to pick some stuff up, and the people we were exchanging homes with decided to nick them. They weren't bloody there. Got a large one here, but I can't see no writing on it to tell me what it is. May not need a 100 watt one. Right, chuck these back in here then. Well, not literally chuck them back in here, because I have glass everywhere. I don't particularly want glass everywhere. If I can help it. Right. No idea if this is 100 or not. But I've got to find out. I know these larger ones are higher wattage than the smaller ones. These are 60s, only go up to 60 watt. Ooh, it looks like there's a load of fly shit all over that. Right. Well, it fills the fitting like the other one. Horrible squeak. Let's have a look. Ooh. No, I don't think that's 100 watt, because this one is definitely, on my right, is definitely brighter to look at. That one might be a 75 watt, that one. That'll do, for the time being. We'll see how much 100 watt is, if I can still get them. Be screwed if I can't get them. Oh. Right. I'm just trying to think of jobs for tomorrow, but because the weather's supposed to be crap, I've got no money to go anywhere with till Thursday. I'm not seeing Mum till Thursday, so I can't go anywhere, can't do anything. I'm stuck in the flat tomorrow. There's no bikes that need doing. I've done them all. And besides, the weather's going to be crap. I can't do any air anyway, so I'll have to do it outside. Because I've got too much junk kicking around in here. That video uploaded yet? Oh, it is. I haven't published that thing. Keep trying to get at least... Well, I've got a question mark and a 5, that's why I should have said 15. Oh yeah, there it is. Where's the reply button? Let's reply. I'll take 15 for it. Would you like to come look / collect? Question mark. There we go. So I relisted the Optima mountain bike this morning, because it's either that or you have to pay Gumtree to bump your ad to the top of the search list, but it's easier just to take it down after a few days and relist it. So I just copy and paste and keep a picture of the bike on the desktop, and then I can just come along and change it as necessary. Ooh. I hope I monetize that. Right. I've been sharing photos of that table on the Lego Facebook groups I'm on. Just so just so you know. Everybody's sharing pages on my post. Oh well. Someone said they wish they had space as well, but well, there's no space for a town, so well, even if I get bored of a street scene, you know, being Lego, I can just demolish it and do something else. I could do a space theme on there or something. That is the beauty of Lego. It's not like the sort of models you'd get with Airfix kits or Warhammer or anything like that. Because once it's made, but with Lego, You can create literally anything you want, and once you're bored with it, you can dismantle it and create something else. It's a reusable art material, as well as a toy, as well as an educational toy. You know, it's Lego is just, I think that's one of the reasons I like Lego so much, because it is such a versatile item. You know, you don't have to just stick to sets, you can build your own things, you can, you know, it's easy. Well, not easy, it's just great stuff. Anyway, I'm going to call that it for this video. If you liked the video, hit the like button. If you didn't, hit the dislike button. It's up to you. Subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll talk to you again soon. Bye.